Hey guys, so how's it going? So in the background right now, you guys are seeing a bunch of little clips going by of me fighting bosses and stuff. So basically off camera, I would just like run around trying to like do different things like get blocks, get sand and stuff, or Skips would be fighting a boss and he'd die and he'd be like, "Hey Fear, you can pick it up if you want, I can't beat it," because he only has like a Magikarp and a level 7 Porygon at the time. And yeah, so that's what you guys are watching right now. And I get some pretty cool loot and some pretty cool TMs from them. So it's pretty cool. And this is me talking over them because I don't have audio for them because I was just in the TeamSpeak talking with the guys. So yeah, I guess we're going to start the real episode now because all the clips are over. Hope you guys like that little catching thingy. Enjoy. Hey, what's up YouTube? FearBlaze here for you guys, another episode of Pixelmon. And we're just hanging out here on the server, guys. And today, I did say I would get a flying-type Pokemon so we could fly around and explore different areas. And I do have my Charmeleon and all my other Pokemon from before, and Charmeleon's dead apparently, okay? But what I'm gonna do is train Charmeleon a bit off-camera really quickly, and then I'll cut back in to get him a little bit closer to level 36 so we get our Charizard, because I really want to start flying around, and it's gonna take like 4 episodes to get him to be a Charizard. So I'm gonna cut really quickly, do a little bit of training, maybe get him up to like level 34-ish or something, and then train the last 2 levels on camera, and then we can go exploring. And then yeah, oh, also guys, Plough did add in some commands to the server that we can kind of fiddle around with. So he added in slash spawn, because hey, keep inventories on, because in Pixelmon, when you die, you're gonna cry, because there's no reason for you to die and lose all your stuff in Pixelmon. It's Pixelmon. So that's why I keep inventories on, and we're gonna kill ourselves anyway just to respawn at spawn. So he said, why not just have slash spawn on? I mean, you guys are gonna kill yourselves anyway with keep inventory. So we marked out the spawn spots with some acacia wood over here. I don't think we'll get to that. I don't know. We'll see. But oh, there's that right there. There's the acacia wood. And then he also added in slash suicide if you want to do that instead. And then he added in slash TPA, which I don't know how I feel about. I really have no opinion. I'm neutral on it. Let me know your guys' opinions. So, like, I don't know where Drink is right now, but I could TPA to him, but I don't know how I really feel about that. So let me know how you guys feel about it. Anyway, I'm gonna go level up my Charmeleon to, like, level 34, 35-ish, and then cut back in. We're gonna evolve him, and then we're gonna go exploring. So, yeah, guys, I guess I'll be back when he's level 34 or 5. Be right back. So our Charmeleon is level 35, and our Growlithe did get a bit of levels there, and our Porygon due to dying and, like, having to swap out and stuff. But it's all cool, guys. Nothing too big happened. And let's see what level this Magmar is. 27. You're gonna get it, buddy. So, I think we'll just fly out any random direction at this point, because I don't think it really matters. But, ooh. Well, what? 3 Blaze Powder, a Blaze Rod, and a piece of Nether. That's not bad, to be honest. That's pretty good. All right, yeah, you cannot battle trainers in this. I've decided that it's official. I cannot challenge any trainer whatsoever. We're gonna battle you, the Raticate, and you're gonna get down really quickly. And you dead, and evolving time. Here we go. Charmeleon into Charizard. Let's see. Here we go. All right, guys, the moment we've been waiting for. Our flying Pokemon, the tank of our team in the future. Probably our gym team and our main team, unless I have to have 2 separate teams. I don't know. But here we go. Well, why are there like 4 bars down there? I'm using default, not any texture pack edit. But Charizard, here we go. Oh, it's so beautiful. Want to learn wing attack? Sure. And did it work this time or did it delete it? Hey, it worked. Sweet. So now we have a Charizard. So let's get back. Let's heal Charizard up because he's the only Pokemon on our team that can actually do something. And we're probably gonna take many Pokemon off of our team really quickly. And like, for example, I really don't want a lot of these Pokemon on my team, in all honesty. Like, Growlithe is probably my number 2, Porygon because he's strong, and maybe Bulbasaur, and I really don't want those 2. In all honesty, I could really care less about them, and I'd rather get Pokemon along the way, and I'm not going to bring a PC because I feel like that's cheap and ruins the adventure. But let's hop on our Charizard, say goodbye to Cloud, and just fly away. Let's just go straight south for the winter, right? Is that how it works? Yeah, something like that. But Charizard's pretty poor Cloud. He's a little flying Pokemon. But let's see if we can run into anything cool. My main goal of this is just to get out of the biome. I'm really sick and tired of Mesa, Savannah, Mesa, Savannah. I want to get something new, something cool, something different. Even just like a forest or a plain, just so I can find different things. It's just, it irks me. I'm tired of deserts too. Just those 3 biomes, just every single place, every corner you turn. Actually, the only thing I want from a desert is one of those larva thingies. What is it? Larvesta, I think? Yeah. It's the only thing I really want. If we can find one of those, that'd be good, because that thing's going to be a part of my team, and it's going to be tanky, and I know it is. There are no Pokemon spawning. Oh, there we go. There's a Graveler. Huh, not much, though. Here's a Mushroom Biome. Oh, this is the Mushroom Biome Slouse found in Episode 1. I don't know if you guys remember that. That was a while ago. Wow, it's going third person. Thing spawning behind me. Nah, I think because I'm on my Charizard, things are not really spawning as frequent, I guess. We're going to bring our negative Z up a bunch, and I don't know. If this is an ocean, I may have to cut and come back with you guys when you find land, because I don't want to be flying forever. Let's see. We'll give it 10 seconds over here, and if we don't find anything, we're going to have to cut. So, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 land. All right, sweet. We good. Wow. I was really hoping I could get a little cut in there, because I knew this wasn't going to be anything big. I want to find good land, like a nice solid forest or something. And I guess it's not bad that there's an ocean there, because... Oh, is this a little island? It is, but there are Pokemon here. Pretty good Pokemon, too. Okay, let's see. There's a Golbat here. I want a Zubat. Is there any Zubats around here? Hey, Golbat, where's Zubat? Where's your child? Let me catch your child. That sounds really mean. Actually, no. I feel bad now. Okay, yeah, but I still want your child. Not that way. Wait, what? No, hold on. Let me rephrase that. No, I already put myself in a hole. Okay, Zubat, there you are. There you are. There you are. Come on. Come on. Kobe. Oh, I missed. Okay. Come on. We gotta hit him. Gotta hit him. Gotta hit him. Gotta hit him. Oh, come on, Charizard. You landed right on top of him. Are you serious? Come on. I gotta get up there and battle him. I really want a Zubat for some reason. I don't know why, but I just want one. Come on. Okay, dude. Are you broken? There we go. And now let's just toss a Dusk Ball at it. Pretty sure we should catch this first try. No big issues with this. Is it bugged? Wait, didn't I just... What? Oh, it's gone now. That's really weird. Anyway, I guess we're going to keep on flying, guys. We now have a Zubat, so that's really, really cool. And is that more land over there already? So, we got to remember, I guess for the next couple episodes, we'll go out in all different directions. So, I got to remember south, and then I'll probably go north next episode, just because it's the opposite. And then maybe east, because that's the way of the Pokemon Center. And then lastly, west, because that's the one weird one that I can't think of. Because right off the bat, I always want to go south, just because I... Flying, bird, south, winter. I don't know why that always comes to mind. But, and then right after that, the opposite of south, north, and then east, because, yeah, has value. Let's see. Another little island. Are there any big land masses here? Like, seriously, come on. Okay, well, we're just going to fly until we find land, I guess. I'll be back when I find something big, guys. BRB. Okay, guys, so we did find some land over here. We came from, obviously, that way over there, and it's kind of... lower, bad. What is that? Is that a Haunter? Oh, it's a Meow. Okay, yeah, let's get on foot now. Because I don't like being on... Oh, I have chat off. I forgot I turned chat off. But what is that? Is that it? I don't know why. I know Mewtwo doesn't spawn, but that birch tree looked like a Mewtwo. Just saying. Okay, but... nice... What the heck? That's a really big Hypno. This is weird. I don't think anybody's really ever been over here. Only because you need to cross that giant ocean to get here. And... I don't think anybody's really interested in going here. Oh, no. Hypno. Listen. Oh, God. If that thing kills me, I'm dead. Oh, my gosh. Oh, there's a grotto. Sweet. Hopefully we get... Oh, Pokeball on the floor. Oh, sweet, guys. We're finding some goodies. A Moonball. Yeah, I gotta turn chat back on. This is really irking me. Commands only. Are commands only also gonna show the things that I get? I don't know how that really works. But there's a grotto here. And I did show in last episode, they just have little loot in them, little Master Ball loots. Let's bust through here, go through the side, through the front, and bam! Waterstone. In all honesty, waterstones are not that rare. I could easily get one if I wanted to just by, like, diving in an ocean or whatever and just grabbing one. But it's not terrible because it saves me the effort that I didn't want to give to get one. So that's nice. But at the same time, you know, a Master Ball would have been nice, just saying. No, Snorlax, listen, man, I know you're good, I know you're a big guy, but I really can't fight you, because you're gonna wreck me. Again, Charizard is my only salvation right now, and he's in my first slot, so he's gonna get aggro. I know I could switch, but I don't want anything else really getting bullied, because I like all the Pokemon on my team. Actually, Porygon. No one likes you, kid. Let's let him die. Who cares? It's Porygon. But let's keep on chugging dead ahead. There's a light ray. Hey, another grotto. Nice. This is what I like about coming all the way out here, guys. There's nobody's been here yet. Nobody. So we have, like, all this land to ourselves. Oh, it's great. Okay, let me check something real quick. Okay, cool. Let's see. Max Elixir. Eh? I think that just, like, heals up your moves or whatever, which is not necessary. Because even when we do, but even when we do battles against each other, we don't allow potions or any of that anyway, because it's just cheap. Because what if I have like 10 hyper potions and you have nothing? It's just like, wow, really? That's really unfair. So please keep it straight up legit battling, use whatever moves you have, and that's it. So that's really pointless getting that elixir there. But you know what? Maybe if somebody wants it for like adventuring, I could hook them up with it. So it's kind of like right up the middle. Sure. Oh, cannot send chat message. Why can't I send a chat message? Okay, whatever. Keep on trying. Oh, Raichu! No, again, I want a Pikachu. I have, like, 3 Thunderstones, and that's all I really want at this point, is to catch the lower... Oh, is that another Grotto? Grotto, whatever it is. Yes, it is. I want to catch the lowest evolutions and then level them up. And another one. Bam! Full heal. Not bad, I guess. I don't really know. And we need some more things. Let's see. Extreme Hills over here. We can get some pretty cool fighting type Pokemon, I guess. I mean, fighting types are always nice to have, and Extreme Hills always have a lot of weird, funky Pokemon. So, it's nice. Let's see. Let's get up in a more centered area, I guess. Man, I really need to record when nobody else is on, because it decreases Pokemon spawns when you're on with a bunch of others. But I guess it makes up for it that we're finding all these grottos and stuff. And yeah, if you guys want to see me train a circuit, Totodile, hop, pa. Nope, that one. There we go. Sweet. Oh, that's so cool. That is so cool. Let's see. Oh wait, what the heck? Okay, 12, level 12. Sound Zubat. Let's go, Zubat. Supersonic. You confused, girl. Let me send out Bulbasaur. Put him asleep, Bulbasaur. There you go. You asleep now. Now we're going to hit you with a Dusk Ball, which catches Pokemon times 4 at nighttime. Oh, it's so cool. That animation of the Dusk Ball just chilling there. It's so amazing. Okay. I'm not going to Vine Whip you, because I know you're going to be a Pansy and die, because I can see that already. But we're going to tackle you one more time, and then we're going to put you to sleep. This is why I love Bulbasaur, man. It's so nice. Oh my gosh. Bulbasaur, you're amazing. But Totodile is not a difficult Pokemon to get, just that you don't see him as much as you'd want. It's like, hey, you only find Totodile when you don't need him. What size are you, by the way? You're a pretty big guy. Giant, yeah. I could tell that you were pretty big. But, yes. I can't say yes. Oh, yeah, I forgot. I'm, like, muted or whatever. Cloud have muted me. Oh, man. All right, But, yeah, now we have a Totodile. That's really nice. Check him out. Oh, it's amazing. Okay, Sableye here. Sableye. I don't really know how I feel about Sableye. I feel like he's OP if you know what to do with him, but he's really underestimated. But again, I don't know because I'm not like a Sableye enthusiast, nor do I really care about Sableye much or really focus Sableye or anything. So it's kind of just like a thing that's there. But hey, who knows? Maybe one day we'll get a Sableye and he'll be on our main team by the end of this Pixelmon series. I don't know. I have no clue. I don't know if I got this out before, but if you guys have a certain Pokemon that I have on my team that you guys want to see me train for next episode, just leave it down below and I will train it. It's cool because I think, I don't want to say we're good with catching Pokemon now, but there are things I want to train. Like I want to train up my Growlithe. There are other things I wouldn't mind training, like the Totodile, I guess, the Bulbasaur I kind of want to train, the, I don't know, there are tons of things like that. Poliwag? Yeah, Poliwag. And things like that. But now we're in a forest, which was a hot spot for last episode, where we caught that Bulbasaur, which was amazing. And, oh, okay, almost fell. If we get another one, I know Drink will cough up something big for it, because he really, hey, village, whoa, cool. What's that? Drowsy, nothing big. Oh, cool, a village is right here, nice. Let's mosey on over here and see what they have in the blacksmith, I guess. I mean, I don't really know. Villagers, what are you guys trading? You guys sell, like, Pokemon? Flint and Steel, what do you give? Bread? I don't need that. Get out of here. Okay, I don't even think they have one. Do they? Please? No. Yeah, they don't. No blacksmith. Let me check. Third person? Nothing. Wow, okay, that's kind of depressing. Whatever. Keep on chugging. Now, I guess, I'm really, no, we have flying type. What was I going to say? I was going to say I'm really tempted to catch that Pharaoh so we can fly around. Then I was like, duh, fear, you got the Charizards is. So yeah, we're good on that. We really haven't found anything too good or too special this episode, which is kind of a bummer, but we have found tons of Grottos so far, and we did catch a Zubat and a Totodile, so that's kind of nice. Totodile is really rare, so not actually, if you know where to look for him, and you have the spots available to look for him, it's not rare, but based on what we've been kind of restricted with, it is fairly rare. You know what would be really weird? If we found another one of those Zapdos shrines right here, that'd be great. And the best part is, I would own it because you can call dibs on it, but I'd feel bad, so I'd probably sell it to somebody. But you gotta let me know, because if I'm trading a Zapdos shrine to you, you better be giving me like a Mudkip and something else. Like, a Zapdos shrine isn't anything to just cough up like, oh yeah, here's a Zapdos shrine. Check inside of this Pokemon Center, by the way. Anything cool happening in here? Well, you can pick up these, right? Yeah, boy, we can. Alright, whatever, let's just take one. Not because I don't feel right using them throughout the adventure, because it's kind of like, oh, my Pokemon died, let me just swap out. But if we do run into anything super duper rare, I won't feel bad using it, because if I fight a legendary and I die to it, I'm not going to let it just despawn just to, quote unquote, be 100%. Well, it is fair, because it is a part of the game. I didn't want to battle it, by the way, I just wanted to fly. But it is a part of the game, so it's all cool, but at the same time, it's really weird. It's a really touchy subject. Because in the real Pokemon, you can't just like plop down a PC and like heal your Pokemon and switch them out whenever you want. But if I'm fighting a legendary, all jokes aside, I want to catch that thing. I don't really care for the most part. I'm doing what's needed to be done to catch it, man. But maybe that's just me. Maybe that's just how I think. And, Ultra Ball Loop. Okay. Sunstone. Yay. Okay, that's not bad. Sunstones are... I guess, because there's only, like, one Pokemon off the top of my head that I can think of that you can evolve it. I think you can evolve... Alright, sweet, Fashion made his Pokedex. Congrats, Fashion. But I know you can evolve into a Blossom using a Gloom with it, but that's the only thing that really comes to mind really badly. Nothing else, really. And, wow, this forest is dead, guys. Oh, my gosh. This is bad. This is so bad, guys. There's like nothing here. Wow. Well, I think this may be a sign to end the episode fairly soon. But I want to catch one more Pokemon for you guys. Let's look for anything in the water. Maybe like a Magikarp, a Staryu would be nice. I love Staryu. Tentacruel. Is there a Tentacruel anywhere? Magikarp. Magikarp's calling me, guys. Tentacruel again. Tentacruel. You see, man, again, Tentacruel is your pre-evolution, so I prefer him. No offense. What is that? Oh, there it is. Tentacool. Hey, buddy. Okay, so let's send out our one and only big bad Bulbasaur, the champ himself. Bam, you asleep. And now we're gonna hit you with a Vine Whip. Don't kill it. Nice. I love Bulbasaur, guys. Oh my gosh, it's so amazing. And Ultra Ball. And this should catch it. And that means this episode we would have caught a Zubat, a Totodile, a Tentacool, and found a lot of loot in about 20-ish minutes. So, that's really nice, guys. And remember, there we go, we got Tentacool. Hey, nice. So, I do need to train all these Pokemon up to get them evolved and stuff, guys. Because, again, it is a catch-em-all series, not a competitive series in any way, shape, or form besides the gyms. But that is a lot for the future, and my Fire Gym is still coming along because we have... Boom! And boom! 36 and 26. So, that's really nice. And now we can fly around. So if you guys have any suggestions for next episode, like, hey, Fear, you should go find a this biome and try to catch a this Pokemon. Or, hey, Fear, you should level up your Growlithe to level 46, like you said, or try to, and spend the next two episodes doing that and get your Arcanine. Or, hey, Fear, you should, find a swamp and look for Mudkip. I don't know, something like that. Just, if you guys can give me a goal for next episode, that would be fantastic, because I do have things in mind. But again, it's always nice knowing what you guys want to see. But I guess this is going to be it for this episode of Pixel. We found a Grotto. Just running around. We found a Grotto. Last one. Come on, guys. Master Ball, no whammy. 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 Water Stone. Fiddlesticks. All right, whatever. But I guess this is it for this episode of Pixelmon, guys. If you guys did enjoy, please hit that like button. Show some support for Pixelmon. Put a smile on my face. Hopefully, I put a smile on your guys' face. This is another Grotto. Oh, yeah, but it's not. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.